Hello, I'm Patrick Walchuk. Welcome to an update on the Ottawa real estate market to the end of August 2020. We'll start out with the general stats for all of Ottawa, as we usually do. So for the month of August only, there were 1,423 homes that traded hands, and that's an increase of 17%. By the way, I'm going to round off numbers that may look just a little bit different than what you're seeing on the screen. So again, sales were up 17%. Breaking that down into freehold versus condo, there were 1,000 freehold homes sell, and that's an increase of 23%. There were 423 condominiums sell, and that was an increase of just 3%, interestingly enough. The average price for a freehold home was $571,000, and that was a huge increase of almost 23%, but that's in keeping with what's been going on in previous months. For condominiums, the average sold price was $389,000, and that's an increase of 25%. I'm not sure if I misstated freehold, that was an increase of 19%. So moving on in terms of how long it was taking for properties to sell, freehold sold in 14 days, get this, compared to 31 days last year, 14 compared to 31. For condominiums, they were selling in 19 days compared to 43 days last year. And in terms of the inventory levels, and this is the key component why prices are going like this, right? Why they're increasing so much. So for freehold homes, there's only 548 of them on the market, and that's a decline of 64%. Condominiums, 372 of them. And if you remember, there were 423 sell, so there's less than a month's supply of condos on the market. So anyhow, 372 are actively for sale as we record this movie, and that's a decline of that's actually a slight increase of 39%. So the condominium inventory has been low for quite some time now. Breaking it out in the three major neighborhoods, we'll start by looking at Orleans. There were 228 homes sell in Orleans. That's an increase of 21% over August of last year. For freehold sales, there were 175 homes sell, and that's an increase of 25%. Condominiums, there were 53, and that's an increase of 10% over August of last year. The average freehold price is $567,000 in Orleans, and that's an increase of about 21%. Condos, the average price is $348,000, and that's an increase of 35% over last year. So obviously condos doing very well in Orleans. Moving to the southwest end of the city right now, looking at Barrhaven. There were 197 homes sell in Barrhaven. That's an increase of almost 70% over August of last year of the total number of homes sold. Looking at freehold, there were 169 sales, and that is an increase of almost 66%. Condominiums, 28 of them sold, and that's double the amount that sold in August of last year. Again, 28 condo sales. The average price for freehold homes in Barrhaven, $593,000, an increase of 20%, pretty consistent again with the other parts of the city and with the past few months. Condominiums, the average sold price was $348,000, and that's an increase of 25%. Now we'll move on to our last area that we monitor, and it remains the king of these major areas in terms of the average sold price, and that is Kanata. So the total sales in Kanata were 183. That's an increase of almost 34%. Breaking it down into freehold, we had 163 freehold sell. That's an increase of 40% over last year. Condos, there were 20. There were about 20 last year. There's 21, so it's flat. In terms of prices for Kanata, freehold, the average sold price, $614,000, an increase of 20%. Condos, $364,000, an increase of 34%. So if you enjoy watching these movies, you'll see the subscribe button on the bottom of your screen. Click that. If you have any questions, give us a call.